Hello everyone. Today we are going to discuss about writing a literature review, which is one of the most important aspects of any research or any kind of investigation. So, learning objective, at the conclusion of this topic, you will be able to know about literature review, features of literature review, begin to write your literature review. So, now what is literature review? A review of literature is an essential part of research. The review of literature includes locating or identifying the literary resources, studying and analyzing the literary resources, evaluating and summarizing literary resources. So, review of literature basically deals with literary resources. It could be in the form of books, article, journal, newspaper, anything. Now, no research activity is possible in isolation. It has to be dependent upon the accumulated knowledge in the past. So, without the knowledge of the past, we cannot do further studies. So, while writing research report, researcher must review previous or existing literature in any form. Now, no doubt reviewing a literature is time consuming, but it is one of the most important, useful and relevant phase of research or investigation. And reviewing literature also requires a lot of patience. Now, what is the review of literature? In a simple word, we can say it is one of the major steps in the process of research. It is a comprehensive overview of existing research on a particular problem. It's every research begins from where the previous researchers have left it and try to add in the existing fund of knowledge. Now, the literature review means going through published articles, related portions of encyclopedias, careful review of research journals, books, dissertations, theses, and other sources of information on the problem to be investigated by the investigator or researcher. According to Walter R. Bauch, the literature in any field forms the foundation upon which all future work will be built. So we can say that literature review is very much important. It serves as a basis or a foundation. There is one analogy which is given by Array. A researcher might say, the work of A, B, and C has discovered this much about my question. The investigation of D has added this much to our knowledge, and I promise to go beyond D's work in the following manner. So it means it helps to add more and more fund in the fund of knowledge. Now, according to Creswell view, the literature in a research study has several purposes, like it shares with the reader the result of the other studies that are closely related to our study being reported. It relates the study to the larger ongoing dialogue in the literature about a topic, and it also helps to fill various kind of gaps and extend prior studies. It provides a framework for establishing the importance of the study. Now, what could be the purpose of literature review? First of all, it plays an important role and a critical role in scholarship because science remains first and foremost a cumulative endeavor. So, literature of review helps us to accumulate the various kind of researches or a study. And in any academic of discipline, it is very much important to synthesize what has already been happened and there in the past. So it also helps to identify what has been written on a subject or a topic, and it also determines the extent to which a specific research area reveals any interpretable trends or patterns. It also helps to aggregate empirical findings related to a narrow research questions to support evidence-based practice and generating new frameworks and theories, and also it identifying topics or questions requiring more investigation. That has basically said by Pierre Trudel, Janu and Christians. Now, why it is important? First of all, it helps to avoid duplication, useless and irrelevant problem areas. To understand research methodology, tools and instruments, statistical method, which prove to be useful, and it provides the overview about the recommendation of previous researches for further research. Now, Cooper argued that given the cumulative nature of science, trustworthy account of past research from a necessary condition for orderly knowledge building. Yet research method textbook in the social science show remarkable lack of attention to how an inquirer finds, evaluate, and integrate past research. So review of literature help us to integrate the past research also. Then there are certain types of literature review, like according to Burmistrol Roy F. and Mark R. Leary, Mark R. Fink, L. Rene, 2005, they have mentioned that there are different kinds or types of literature review, like argumentative review, integrative review, historical review, methodological review, systematic review, and theoretical review. Now, there are various kinds of resources by which, with the help of which, we can accumulate our data or the review of literature. That is, we can use scholarly empirical article, dissertation, and books. We can use non-empirical article and essays, textbook and encyclopedia, dictionary, trade journal and articles, certain nationally and internationally recognized good news magazines. The top two most appropriate sources are academic journal articles and academic books, but it should not be textbook. Now, the next aspect is writing the literature review. It is one of the most important that how to write the literature review. No doubt we are able to study the literature review. We are able to collect the whole reviews or data or the information related to a particular study. But it requires a proper skill and a training to write the literature review in a proper manner. So according to Linda Fredrickson, he has given some tips like literature reviews about both content and a form. We have to take into consideration the content and the form in which we are going to write the literature review. In terms of content, keep in mind that your literature review is intended to, first of all, set up a theoretical framework for your own research. Show clear understanding of the key concept, ideas, studies, models related to your topic. Demonstrate knowledge about the history of your research area and any related controversies. Illustrate that you are able to evaluate and synthesize the work of others. Clarify significant definitions and terminology. Develop a space in your discipline for your research. Now, the literature review basically clearly describes the questions that are being asked. They also locate the research within the ongoing scholarly dialogue. This is done by summarizing current understandings and by discussing why what we already know tends to the need for the present research. So literature review also define the primary concepts. While this information can appear in any order, these are the elements in all literature reviews. Now, some questions to ask yourself when you begin to write your first draft include: how will my literature review be organized? Chronologically, thematically, conceptually, methodologically, or a combination? What section heading will I be using? How do the various studies relate to each other? What contribution do they make to the field? What are the limitations of a study? Where are the gaps in the research? And finally, but most importantly, how does my own research fit into what has already been done? Some question to ask after the first draft: is there a logical flow from section to section, paragraph to paragraph, sentence to sentence? Does the content proceed from topic to topic? Does your conclusion match your introduction? Were you consistent in documenting and using the correct citation style? Now, the feature of writing literature review, we have to take into consideration the three main part or aspect: introduction, body, and conclusion. Now, when I talk about introduction, the introduction basically contains a statement or statements about the overall topic of your dissertation or a thesis or any research project. This might be a paragraph or section that lets your reader know that what your literature review is going to address. In the introduction, you will define or identifying the journal topic, issue, or area of concern, thereby providing an appropriate context for the remainder of the review. point out overall trends in what has been previously published on the topic? Or is there any conflict in theory, methodology, evidence, conclusion, or gaps in research and scholarship? Establish your reason for reviewing this research. Explain the criteria used to search the literature, the organization of the review, and if necessary, why certain literature either is or is not included. Now, the next is demonstrate how your research either closes a gap in the literature, extend earlier work, or replicates an important study, thereby contributing new knowledge to your discipline. So it helps to cover various kind of gaps. More tips for the introduction. Consider presenting a historical frame of reference. Point out a landmark or seminal study. Provide definitions for important terms. Describe how your literature review was conducted. Describe any inclusion or exclusion criteria used. Next is a body, the main part of the literature review. Start broad and then narrow to show how past research relate to your study. Make it clear to your reader where you are going. Follow logical progression of ideas. When appropriate, cite two or more sources for a single point, but avoid long string of references for a single point. Use quotes. Then keep your own formal academic voice throughout and keep the review focused and objective, following a logical structure. Point out consistent findings and emphasize stronger studies over weaker ones. Point out important strengths and weaknesses of research studies or contradiction and inconsistent findings, implication and suggestions for further research, or where there are gaps in the current literature should be properly addressed. Now the conclusion. Summarize your, it is very much important to conclude the literature review. Summarize your literature review, discuss implications, and create a space for future or further research needed in this area. Like the introduction, this section should be around 3 to 5 pages in length. How do you know when you are done? Can you answer these 11 questions? Have you clearly defined your topic and audience? Did you search and research the literature? Took notes while reading? Chosen the type of review you want to write? Have you kept the review focused throughout? Were you critical and consistent in your evaluation and synthesis? Is the structure of your review logical? Did you make use of feedback? Were you be able to stay relevant and objective throughout? Did you maintain an objective voice? Did you cite current and older studies? So these 11 points basically given by Piotrowski. Now there are certain list of references. It is very much important you have to give the list of references because you have to cite it properly. The reference list of publication used in your literature review serve two purposes. First, it provides your reader with a means to evaluate the quality of your research. Second, accurately and correctly citing all the sources used in your work protects you from possible accusation of plagiarism. Using the word or ideas of other without referencing your source is a very serious academic offense. So references is very much important whenever you have to cite anything. Now the reference list is a reflection of the thoroughness of your review. It also allows others to retrieve the publication you cite, error made in author's name, journal or article titles, page number and dates may present barrier to retrieval of articles and may prevent giving credit to authors for their work. Each reference should be checked carefully for errors. Every in-text citation must have a listing in the references and every title in the reference list should connect to an in-text citation. Now these are some of the references. You may refer this for further. So thank you. So I can conclude that it is very much important whenever you have to do any research or investigation, the first and the foremost part is you have to review the literature. Without reviewing the literature, we are not able to achieve our objective. Thank you everyone. Have a nice day.